people that did this community. So this is me. So that's it, it's not this, just a picture. But, so I had the problem at the time. I love gadgets. I love gadgets, and because I love gadgets, I have a lot of friends. And I love to play gadgets. So next. So I want to present the Mobile Monday. So how many people know about Mobile Monday? Or the concept of Mobile Monday? Okay. So Mobile Monday is one of the first concepts in, how can I say, mobile, that bring people together for different companies. Doesn't matter. I don't know if you know, from some years ago was a very strong fight between Nokia and Microsoft. Can you imagine this? Nokia and Microsoft to fight. Blood, war. And some guys in Finland, so you will see one of them, meet together and say, hey guys, let's make something to break this, you know, this world, this corporate world. And this means was started a community, when the people said, okay, we want to make something together, they put together and build something. Next. You know these guys? This guy? Who knows this guy? No, you, I know that you know the other guy. Let the other. Who knows who is this guy? You know?
Yeah.
You know him? So next. Now you know him? You know this guy? So this is Peter Westerbacher, and Peter, I met him in 2010. The Mobile 2.0 in Barcelona. I said, hey then, you know, I was starting a new project. It's called Angry Birds. It's a very cool stuff, but you know, it's my eighth try, so big try. So I don't know how much, 10 years or something like this, 12 years. He tried, he failed.
56 times. 56 games before.
Yeah, but eight big. So 8 big projects. So next, please. So you know this stuff? How do I?
Yeah.
So it's in Bucharest, so I think it's a very successful stuff. And they have now acceleration program, and you know, it's evolving from a community basis. So I talked with Bogdan asking, so why, where do you start this? Because I talked with some friends and said, hey, why not organize them to be the community, where to know, how can you just make a startup, how can you make money from the web? So next. So, Republica. Who knows what Republica is? So, Republica is the biggest conference of bloggers. So, started as a blogger, social media in Germany. This year, were some 7,000 people at Republica. 7,000 people. What is interesting in their concept is that they talked with big brands and said, hey guys, you know, I love you because you're sponsors, but we want to integrate in our design. So the brands were not represented with their, you know, big brands and, you know, big booth and all this stuff that they have normally. They were integrated in the wild. So in the concept of the conference. The first conference in the world that said, hey, we don't want to have your brand, we want to have you, you know, integrated in our concept. And this was very cool. Next, please. And what is very interesting is that they write a book in the time of Republica, because they are bloggers, they are very good to write. They started and write a book in these 3 days. And the book is very interesting. It's very interesting to read. So second. Next, please. So Google developer groups. So everyone asked me, are you working for Google? And I said, I will make you a t-shirt. I am not working, I'm not working for Google. Because everyone asks me, I don't work for Google. I like the people that are working or that are organizing the Google developer groups. So I know a lot of Google developer groups in the world, and I can tell you some aspects of this. Some guys in Nigeria, they have very good Android developers, and they send the developers to Tbilisi, Georgia, to make some courses. And they asked Google, hey, you can help us with the transportation and so on. And we said, no, you know, there's no interest, you know, our interest is the West, it's no, you know, we don't put money in this. And then the government of Georgia, some of the government, and said, hey guys, we can sponsor all the trips for the Nigerian guys, developers to come to Tbilisi and make this happen, these courses for Android. And this was for me the first step that said, hey, Google developer groups normally are not dependent on Google. The Google developer groups are very independent and they help one to another, the community. But more interesting message is, so here are some events on Google developer groups worldwide. So next please. So one day in the Google developer group, so you can see you can have, and most of them are streaming, so you can go and learn a lot of stuff about, let's see, develop mobile application with Android. So GDG, John Android, Arduino. Is Arduino to Google? No. But the people who work with it, so they love it. So next, please. So, DevOps. Who knows what DevOps is? DevOps is the biggest developer conference, I think, in Europe, on Java. So they started in Brussels. Last year they had, I don't know, 4,000 people. They extend out to France and Poland. It's a very, very cool conference. And it's built from community to community. So next, please. So UXCamp, I was this week at the UXCamp. Was the sixth edition. How many people are working with UX or design? Yeah.
Working with, but I'm not a designer.
Okay. How many people have contact with UX people in their company? Okay, great. So, 7 years ago in Germany, nobody knows about user experience designers. And everyone said, oh, we are developers. We know how to build the interface. We know how to our customer need. We know everything. Now, when you take a look at the map of user experience, Germany, Poland, and Czechs are number one in Europe. And they have very good products. Because they build products in these countries. Because to build a product, you need the UX guy. When you take a look at the map of startups, Airbnb, you know, Airbnb. So in Airbnb are co-founder, two UX guys. So to build a startup, to have a way to start, you need a UX guy. So next please. So I'm coming to my lab, Redcon. You know what Redcon is? No? How many people are developing here? Okay. How many people are business here? Okay. How many students are here? Okay, great. But the students have a question. Well, what are you studying?
Automatic and computer science.
Automatic control and computer science.
Ah, okay, great. So we'll come to you. So Android. How much you know about Android? So I can tell you something, in Oradea, the university, I have two colleagues of mine, they are the second year and they make this operating system based on Android. And they are very happy with this. Because Android now is on phones, Android will be on wearable, Android is on, I will show you some multicast for TV, for streaming. So Android is fast everywhere. So, Android will have, at the end of this year, 2 billion devices, smartphone devices, and another, I think, 1 billion wearable. You can imagine, 3 billion wearable. So it's a market that you can produce applications, produce everything, 3 billion. It's very big. So, Android, I had today a meeting with someone from Google, and he said, we don't want to support Android, because Android is not our product from Google. I said, yeah, but you can sustain the community and so on, you can invest in our community. No, no, I don't know. And why? Who knows Nokia X, the phone? It's an Android phone. But where is the store? It's a Google Play?
No.
No,
Nokia.
It's completely different. For example, in Russia, it's a very cool device. I don't have here because it's somewhere, it was coming from Russia. European borders, they have some problem with products from Russia. And it's blocked somewhere in the border, soil. The customs. And it's a very cool device that you have, not only your screen, on the other screen is an inkjet. So you can personalize with what do you want. So it's a very cool device. A device that I haven't seen it. And they have their own store. So it's Android device with their own store. So what is interesting, the Android community is very distributed. So you'll see different skills and specialties. So next please. So the Draco is 5 years now, and it's double the number every year. So we have now in 20 towns, 2014, 20 towns, big towns from New York to so Berlin, London, Madrid, Paris, Paris, Bucharest, Bucharest, Baku, Moscow, we'll have one in Krakow for Poland, and so on. So, I love this in German, I was Susanne. Who speaks German?
Hey, okay, everybody together, no?
Yeah. Very good. So, learn, work, share, and hack. So, next please. So, this is the worker distribution. Next please, I want to follow with this. So, this was great. Moscow. What I want to show you is, for example, you see the language here? It's Russian. So they said we don't need English, we speak Russian, we are Russians, we speak Russian. So we put everything in Russian. Next please. So this is our sound of the great code. And you see, you can see some standards here. So this is Tel Aviv, Torino, this is Stockholm, this is Madrid, this is, oh, I must remember. But this is Bucharest. In Bucharest, this is Berlin. It's very, very simple. It's community based. So this is Amsterdam. This is Paris. This is Tunisia. This is normal ADE in Ankara. And this is Moscow. Next. So next. So this is Berlin, India. So this guy said, yeah, we organize events, but let's make open source all the software behind all the for the event. And you can see, you can take this and use for your events. Just graphical form, put on a server and you can use for all event. And they have very good call for papers, everything. So it's very good. So next please. So what I've learned in these years. So in the first step, you must love your community. And be volunteer. So I was the first year's volunteer. I work, and now I work for nothing. In the second, you remark that you're at the beginning will be maybe 5-10 people. But this, if you grow in this organic, will grow. And the sleep phase is franchise model. So Draco is a franchise. You can take if you want to make, for example, in I don't know. In Sofia or in Kiev. So, what do you make from here to here is a difference because at the beginning you make everything volunteer, you remark that you have no time. You need more people. So, to engage more people, you need more money to be professional. But this is a stage that everyone will love, and once it's very difficult because you'll go from the, you know, from something that's volunteer to something that is paid. And you must take care about compromises, not to make too much compromises. But you'll enjoy your community evolution. So, next please. So, next, I think we will go fast. Next, franchise, in the future, okay, next. Ah, what I want to say is this platform in Russia, and I love very much because what they have made, they put all developers together. So they have at this moment 60,000 developers on their platform. And what they build for developers, they build tools to help them, for example, for apps, to have a lot of downloads, to see, to analyze the markets. Because a lot of developer company doesn't have idea about advertising, about marketing. And as a developer, you don't must learn this. You are a developer, you make good stuff as a developer company and not as a marketing. And that's why they build a lot of applications. This is something that they call billboard for apps. And you can see this is the ranking of the app, because they are crawling all the app stores and analyzing with artificial intelligence all the information. And they put a ranking here, and you can see, you can find this in the app store. This Action Media is on Apple Store and on Google Play. But that sounds different, because they have for all developers, inclusive Mac, Windows, Windows 8, all developers together. Okay, I think that's it from my side. If you have questions, come that I haven't borrowed it, because I want to show you, you can make your community, you can build your community, you can have success. Yes, please.
This apps for all, is it only for testing, or you can also give out like shouts to the community, like engage some developers to do some work, or does it work also that way?
Yeah, they have more parts. So they have a part of aggregation from news and so on. And very good news, because they selected the best news that are really relevant for developers. Second, they have different tools for apps, so to increase the downloads of the apps, to search for testing now, at this moment. Once they have they build, for example, now they build communities for corporates. So Intel in Russia said, hey, we know that a lot of developers are developing for Intel, but we have no idea who they are. And they make many guys say, the guys who develop for Intel can put just a small logo with Intel, and everyone is looking on their website knows. Fourth, they have, for example, a contest of ideas. So everyone, every company puts his idea. And at the end, the winner receives 20,000 euros of the equivalent of Apple's here, and they can build this application. So it's really, everything is for community, and everything is investing in a community. So, yeah, more questions from your side?
We have something similar outside of Russia like this.
Yeah, we'll be, yeah. It's
we'll be.
Yeah. So, from your side, so I have a lot of stuff here. So Google Glasses, I think you know Google Glasses, don't you? How many people have them on Google Glasses?
Only nine.
Okay. So this is Google Glasses. So I'll let you, everyone can play it, open it. These are the Epson, but it's BT100. So normally up here, so it's now on the market, a new one, it's BT200, it's not so big, it's smaller, it's half of this. And this is bioscopic. So Google Glasses you have just, it's mono. So this is bioscopic, you can try it. Have you put something on 3D? No? Okay. So you can try it, it's probably the Android here. So this is the controller. These are the glasses. So very good stuff. And I have here, the, who knows what this is? You know this? This is a sphere, so you can control this with, for example, the hackathon in Cluj last week was some guy that control everything from motion. So was that one developer says, I have two dogs and I'm too lazy not to play with the dogs. And say, I'm staying on my sofa and I managed to move the ball with...
Can you make a demo of that?
Excuse me?
We have a demo?
I don't have a demo here. But a demo for Leap will have our Brad? You have a demo for Leap in some minutes. Oh, okay, great. So now is working someone to show you a little about Leap with motion. So then what I have here, so in the magic.
Must take a look because maybe I can get
some. So then I have Miracast from Parker One Touch. And it's a very cool device. I have it at my home. Is you put on your TV and you can stream everything and you can make a lot of fun stuff. So I put a Node.js on top of this, and I put my web page, and I control everything so from my tablet. So it's a very cool device, and it's open, so you can put everything on the software and everything on top of this. So it's Android. So what the hell am I supposed to do?
Inter
Galileo. You know Inter Galileo? No? So it's a board that Inter wanted to position Raspberry Pi, Samsung, Raspberry Pi. See? You have your students at automatic mode. Automatic mode. You don't know this? You know this? Galileo? Okay, great. You have made some project or not? Sensors and so on, no question?
No, I'm not going.
Okay, so this is a very good device, the price will be very, very good. So the most impressive... So who knows what this is? Beacons? Is something for you, beacons?
They look like tic-tac boxes.
So if you put the battery inside 1 year and with Bluetooth low energy, you can present information at distance, you can put some information about to identify an object or place or something like this. They're very good. These are produced from a company from Cluj. And I use this for every hackathon. In Turkey at the hackathon, there was a guy that said, hey, I have a, I forget the Sony smartwatch, I have a beacon, and I have a dog. I said, okay, every time I have a problem, I ask my dog, so you know, in the park, and I go with my dog out. What he said, is, okay, you take it out from here, you know, the electronic is so big, and you put on the dog, yes, yeah. And then, what he made, he put a different texture of vibration on the smartwatch. So when the dog was near, was no problem, when the dog was 5 meters, then small vibration, 10 meters, strong vibration, 15 meters, then really vibration. And when he was looking at the smartwatch, he has a direction for the where's the dog. So very cool stuff. So these are the beacons.
So what's the range of those beacons?
Excuse me?
What's the actual range of the beacons?
70 meters. Oh. If you have free space. So when you have a wall, it's difficult. You know, it's 70-10 meters. For 70 meters.
And those are made by company Cluj.
Yeah, company Cluj is called Onyx Beacon. They have an SDK. At this moment, they are looking, so they are helping me to find you know, what API to open and how can they build this. If you want to, I will put you in contact with them. So this is the. Cool.
You'll be able to play with it afterwards.
So you can play with everything from this, you can take a look at this, you can ask me questions. Have something, you know, get something.
Yeah,
it's connected with the phone. It's good as low energy, it's connected with the phone. So now I think it costs us something like 128 on eBay. You know, it's, the price is very good. This is business edition, so it's, I think it's 10 million people because of the.
This is the second edition, right?
Yeah, second edition, yes.
It's not, they said it also in America for 600
bucks. Yes, 600. That's a good price. So you can have in Germany for 110 now. Yes, okay, if you have questions from your side, so how can we do better? So you want to make your presentation, what you need to make? So just 10 minutes to tell our presentation about GDG and yeah. Question if you want to have now, we can talk after this. So we have 24 minutes to 8. So at least